We have a special presentation right now, and I'd like to introduce to you a man who stays behind the scenes pretty much here during the show. He's the proud owner of 2 Stanley Cup championship rings as the official scorer for the Red Wings. However, to all of us at Blue Water Brass, we're more proud of the fact that for 25 years, Phil Martin has been our show director to help organize this and get the course lined up. I'd like to introduce to you our show director. Will you give him a big hand, Mr. Bill Martin?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Appreciate you being here to help us celebrate our 25th anniversary. We're very pleased tonight to have Jeff Fiedler, who is the director of the Cavaliers, but also very, very important, is the chairman of the board of Drum Corps International. So at this time, I'd like to turn it over to Jeff Fiedler.
Thank you, Bill. Good evening. What makes a summer great is that not only do you have big shows on weekends, you have big shows on weeknights. And the Blue Water Brass and shows like it provide us a place every evening of the week to perform, whether it's here in Michigan or in Pennsylvania or in Arkansas or California or Texas or something like that. Drum Corps International is 31 years old. For 25 of those 31 years, the Blue Water Brass has been a part of the Drum Corps International Tour. It is with 2 other shows that Drum Corps International has, one in Erie, Pennsylvania, and one in Rome, New York, the most continuous, oldest show running on our tour. And on behalf of the Board of Directors of Drum Corps International and our Executive Director, Dan Atchison, I would like to present Mr. Martin and his committee with this plaque from Drum Corps International for 25 years of outstanding contributions to the Summer Music Games Tour and the Drum Corps activity. Thank you.
Thanks, Jeff. We have another presentation at this time. During the last 20 plus years, this committee has worked very hard to bring you a best show that we could bring you all during the Drum Corps years. It's at this time I would like to call Andy Pocadilla, who's been our general chairman for those 20 plus years, to the front here and present him with a plaque in recognition of the effort and time that he has given to this show. Andy? It's hard to understand exactly what this gentleman has done for this show. The seats you are sitting on, do you see them numbered? Do you see them painted? He and 2 or 3 other people have come out about every 3rd or 4th year and have actually done that work. He not only has done that, he is an extremely organized person. He runs our meetings very well. And believe me, he makes sure that things are done right. Ladies and gentlemen, Andy is retiring after this year. And the show is going to go on, but I'm telling you, Andy's going to be hard to replace, but he will be replaced. But please give him a big, big hand. Thank you very much. You know, I've said before, this cannot be a one-man show, as you understand. I have a committee of about 20 committees, with chairmen in each committee, who have several workers that work with those chairmen, and they all do their job so well, which makes my job much easier.
We start our work in either January or February each year with the date of the show, knowing which chords are coming, and we start with making all the arrangements that are necessary for an evening like this. And these committee chairmen are so competent, their workers work so well with them, that we've got an organization that is really well oiled, and we're very proud of it. It has been fine-tuned over the last 25 years and is in really good shape. Myself and seven or eight others feel that after 25 years, we need to turn this over to younger people, younger boosters, and we have already met twice with these boosters and explained the kinds of things that have to be done to put on a show like this. We also have committed ourselves to be advisors for at least a year or two with the new organization, so that they are not just picking things up without direction. And I'm sure it will work and will survive. The band directors of both our Courtyard High Schools are very enthusiastic about continuing Blue Water Brass. I feel that next year about this time we'll all be back here, and I probably will be up in the stands enjoying the show, which will be kind of nice, because you don't see a whole lot down here on the field. You get a much better view halfway up in the middle of the stadium. But anyway, I really want to thank everyone, all of my staff and workers, for their loyalty and enthusiasm and dedication to Blue Water Brass. I feel that we have done a lot for the community in bringing a fine program here, and also we have given financial assistance to our two Portland High School band instrument programs. And for this, we're very proud. So thank you for your loyalty and coming to our shows, and continue to do so. We try to bring in the best chorus possible for you to see, and I'm sure this will go on for years to come. Thank you. You can have all the committee people come out here. These are just some of the people that work year-round to make this happen. And we're not going to introduce everybody, but we wanted them to step out on the field and be recognized. So will you please give them a big hand? They do a great job. We're ready to begin the retreat. Thank you.
And now what you've all been waiting for, the judge's decision. In eighth place, with a score of 39.20, from Grand Rapids, Michigan, Dimensions!
Presenting our special thanks to Dimensions from the Port Huron Exchange Club, Chuck Faulkner. In seventh place with a score of 40.85 from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario, the Bandettes. And our Adopt-A-Core sponsor, Radio First, and Andy's going to give them a special presentation. In sixth place, with a score of 44.30, from Erie, Pennsylvania, the Lake Erie Regiment. For a sponsor, Flagship Federal Credit Union, and their representative, Pat Hills. In fifth place, with a score of 50.50, from Marion, Ohio, the Marion Cadets. Representing Topolowski and Associates, our own Andy Bocadillo. In fourth place, with a score of 62.0, from Columbus, Ohio, Capital Regiment. And the sponsor is John Rowling Real Estate, John Rowling. In third place, with a score of 62.95, from Kitchener, Ontario, the Kiwanis Cavaliers. Our sponsor is the Fort Gratiot Rotary, Dave Davis. In second place, with a score of 68.20, from Orlando, Florida, Magic of Orlando. From the Lottery Banquet Center and Faulkner's Catering, your Adopt-A-Core sponsor. And the 2003 Bluewater Brass Champions in first place with a score of 81.60 from Rosemont, Illinois, the Cavaliers. We want to let all the core members know, and all of you in the audience know, that the special boxes that they're being presented with, hopefully they'll put to good use on the bus tonight. They're all little Debbie cupcakes for all of you. We want to thank you for coming to Port Huron. Drum majors, you may return to your corps. Another big hand for all of these great young people. Thank you. come on, folks, you can do better than that. These kids have been traveling for weeks. You may leave the field. Cavaliers, we look forward to your encore presentation. Everyone, stay seated for just a few moments. While they're getting ready, there have been some questions being asked down here about where the course stay and so forth. These kids came in about, most of them, probably 3 o'clock or 3:30 this morning. They all had a show someplace else. They got about 4 hours sleep on the gym floors, and then they were up doing calisthenics, having breakfast, getting warmed up, and they have been on the field all day. And then they take little breaks for lunch, and then they practice again and take little breaks for dinner. And they will leave tonight. Many of them will drive all the way to Wisconsin, about 10-hour drive, and some are going to Iowa, which is even longer. So they'll probably get maybe 2 hours sleep tomorrow morning on a gym floor. So it's incredible the amount of dedication it takes for them to do this every year, and it never ceases to amaze me. These kids are just incredible. I think our future's in good hands, and I'm grateful to all of them. So.
Thank you.